commentary.
You're in my spot.
I'm so glad I came out. I don't regret coming out at all. How's everybody doing here at our party? Yes? Are we good? I'm good. I got myself a girlfriend, you guys. I got a girlfriend, yeah.
I know that. Clap for that. He's got a girlfriend. Clap.
Sure. I know some of you saw me walk in here with her. You were like, oh, Rami's finally paying for it. No. It's an actual woman who's actually, I think, attracted to me. That's a real thing. We met on Twitter.
What a weird place to meet.
I know. But you know what, Tyler and everybody else out there, a lot of people out here probably met their significant other on Tinder. And the only difference between meeting somebody on Twitter and on Tinder is on these three fucking letters. So fuck you, okay? We're not weird at all. Here's what happened. I host a sports talk radio show. She listens to my sports talk radio show. We started chatting on Twitter, and then, guys, she slid into my DMs. That's what she did. And it's been good. She's a sports fan. I'm a sports fan. So some people may Netflix and chill. We NBA playoffs and chill. That's how we roll. So I know I'm Dwayne Wade in her head later that night, but that's fine because she's Gabrielle Union in mine. So it's all good. We're cool.
What have you watched this week? There's no sports.
The All-Star Game.
That's not.
I was Chris Bryant. Okay. I don't know who that makes her. I'm not sure. But all right. That's what we watched. We All-Star Game and we chilled. That's what we did, Tom.
ASG and chill, baby.
She's actually the second straight girl that I met on Twitter. The last two girls I've dated, I met on Twitter. And I told my roommate that. He was like, dude, you got to show me how to use Twitter. And I was like, yeah, those are the only two girls I've talked to in the last 3 years. Maybe show me how to communicate with people in real life. That seems like a more useful life skill. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. I don't know. But I blew her mind. I swept her off her feet on the first date. And here's how I did that. You guys want to know how to sweep a woman off her feet on the first date?
How do you sweep a woman off their feet on the first date?
I thought it was like the most basic duty of a man, not even a good man, just a man. I walked her back to her car in the parking garage after our first date, and that blew her mind. So, guys, thank you for setting that bar so low that I can just step right over it. That was easy. That's pretty good. I would walk a woman back to her car after the first date, like, even if she was like, no second date, I'll never fuck you, have a good night. I'd still be like, do you want me to walk you back to your car? Because, like, 9 out of 10 bad things that happen to women in TV and movies happens in a parking garage. So, I don't know. I don't think not liking me is warrant for getting raped and murdered. I don't think that makes...
How do they know that's not what you're planning?
It's funny you should mention that.
Wait, oh, this is a bad date.
Because I've done some research, and it turns out, ladies, that 6 out of 10 guys will walk you back to your car at the end of the first date. 3 of those 6 are going to do what I did, which is give you a peck on the cheek, tell you I had a good time, ask if I could see you again. The other 3, they're going to sexually assault you. That's their plan. That's what they're doing. I think she's a keeper. I think I'm going to keep her around, Tyler.
Wow.
Yeah, I think I'm going to try and keep her around.
This is breaking things.
She convinced me in one moment, Tyler.
Let me tell you something. As a married man,
You're
treading on very...
The knife? Is this the knife I'm treading on? Okay, you tell me if this is...
Tread lightly.
You tell me if this is reason to keep her around, all right? I think it is. I think she's a keeper. Here's what happened. We went on a date. We went to Dave & Buster's. And a side note about Dave & Buster's, like I said, I work in radio. There's not a lot of money in radio, but there's some free shit. Like, I got racks on racks on racks of Dave & Buster's gift cards, you guys. Yeah. And I'm smart. I like to make my money work for me. So I only play the games if you get the orange tickets back that you can go back and use in the gift shop afterwards. And I go back in that gift shop and I fucking make it rain orange tickets, you guys. I'm a Dave & Buster's baller. I go in there, I'm like, you know what? Let me get one of those ring pops. You know what? Give me all the fucking ring pops. Give me all the ring pops, son. So anyways, we went on a date to Dave & Buster's. And we had some cheesy bread, we had some drinks, we played some games, it was a good time. Then we went back to my place afterwards, and she gave me not only the most amazing blowjob I've ever had in my life, the most amazing blowjob any man in this room has ever had in his entire life. I can guarantee you that. I know that because I came so hard that I thought I blew off the back of her head like JFK, because when it happened, she went back and to the left, back and to the left. But she survived. She survived it. She was a trooper.
You came so hard, people said there's a second shooter.
But no, but she was a trooper. She survived it. She was a trooper. And then this was the moment, Tyler. This was the moment. Immediately after the blowjob, that I was convinced that she's a keeper. She nestled up right under my arm here. She just nestled up right under my arm. And then she whispered something in my ear. She just put her mouth right next to my ear, and she said, "The sexiest damn thing I've ever heard of you guys." She said, "Let's go smoke some weed and eat the rest of that cheesy bread." I came again and almost asked her to marry me. Right there on the spot, you guys. Right there on the spot.
Yes!
Yeah.
How much more time do I have, Gary?
How much more do you want to do?
I was kind of done after that, to be honest.
Fuck you!
Give it up for Gary Zajacowski, everybody! Robbie Maklof, everybody! Robbie fucking Maklof!
I'm really glad that we waited for him to come do that. And it's funny, he's like, every part of my being wants to just shut it down!
Does anybody else want to go up again?
I promised you guys another set.
Drew, do you... Like, are you...
I don't know if you guys know what that feels like.
Are you chopping at the bit? I'll leave in the middle of your set, it doesn't matter.
Are you chopping at the bit?